Well, I'd like to bring in Ekaterina Kotrikadze. She's the news director and anchor of TV Rain, an independent Russian news outlet. She joins us now live from Tbilisi, Georgia. Ekaterina, thank you very much for taking time to speak to us here on the show. What we have been seeing here on CNN and from our correspondents on the ground across Ukraine is really terror being inflicted right across the population here, bodies being piled up on the streets, some of them, in fact, with bullets on their backs, mass graves being uncovered, and then civilians being tricked into buses to Russian-held territory, which is something we've seen in Mariupol. Is any of this, Ekaterina, reaching the people of Russia?
Well, people of Russia have, so far, they have the opportunity to use internet. They still have the opportunity to go on YouTube to watch, for example, YouTube streams that we are doing here, the journalists who were obliged and forced to leave the country. there are several, even a lot of journalists, independent journalists, who have these YouTube streams, and people are watching, and main part of the viewers are from Russia. YouTube is not banned so far, but you know, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, these social media networks are actually banned in Russia, but still people use VPN. And it is really important to understand that new generation in Russian Federation is more sophisticated than Vladimir Putin and his team technologically. They know how to be one step ahead of the regime. So that's why they're still getting the information. And people are posting, you know, there is a story of a father who was aggressively supporting Vladimir Putin's so-called special military operation in Ukraine until he lost his son on this flagship Moskva, which sank. Yeah. And you know, and right now we are all witnessing the process of, you know, waking up of this person, and he suddenly understood what was going on, and he's posting on social media what his feelings are, and he's talking with other relatives and fathers and mothers of Russian sailors who also died on this flagship, and Moscow is not actually saying a word about the victims. So, you know, it's going to be more and more of this kind of stories, unfortunately, and there's going to be more and more people who will understand what was going on and what is going on in Ukraine.
And I saw, Ekaterina, on that point you're making, I saw the post from the father. I think his son was a cook in the Moskva, and he was questioning the fact that, you know, the Kremlin, that Russia was saying that actually they've been rescued, but kind of father was asking, well, my son's missing. Where exactly, how long can they keep this narrative going? So give me a sense, for example, for today, what is the top story in Russia today? What is making news bulletins this hour?
They are liberating the cities and towns of Ukraine. I mean, honestly, this is what they are saying. They are showing people who are thanking Russian army. They do not show the destroyed cities, the destroyed towns. They are not talking about 3-month-old child that you have just mentioned a couple of minutes ago in Odessa who was killed. And they do not show this terrible picture of death. They are, you know, hiring representatives of so-called Russian administrations on the occupied territories, who are making the statements, and they want the 100 million people in Russia to trust this fake statements with thank you so much for coming and for liberating and setting us free from this Nazi regime. This is getting more and more fake. This is getting more and more ridiculous. And I'm pretty sure that there are people who are at least doubting what they are seeing, because there are so many journalists in Ukraine, in different cities of the country. There are so many journalists of independent media who are covering this story and who are banned in Russia. So I suppose there are people who can ask just, you know, one tiny question. What is going on? Why is Russian Federation banning all this international news, or just, you know, independent news outlets? Does it mean that something is wrong here? Why the censorship is here on the ground in Russia? So, yeah, I mean, it means I think it means for millions of people in Russian Federation that there is going to be a moment of understanding, of acknowledging the whole catastrophe.
Ekaterina Kotrikadze, that's what makes your work and other so many other independent journalists so important. Thank you very much for your work, Ekaterina, there. Appreciate it. And Michael, you know, what's staggering just hearing from Ekaterina there is the fact, I don't know if you remember earlier this week, our Clarissa Ward in the field actually went to one town in Ukraine, and she spoke to one couple. And the lady, this elderly lady, Michael, if you remember, she said, you know, she blamed not Russia, but the US. So it's not as black and white, even within Ukrainian territory. This information, misinformation from Russia is seeping through to the borders of Ukraine. And that is incredibly worrying indeed, Michael.